World Championship Wrestling signed Glacier. They had no idea that doing so would change professional wrestling forever. WCW began teasing Glacier's arrival in late April 1996. However, when planning his extravagant debut, they failed to account for several factors. Glacier, a man whose entire background was predicated on being cold, was to have his first match at an event called Bash at the Beach in Florida in July. Temperatures were well into the 80s on July 7th, 1996, when WCW head honcho Eric Bischoff realized this huge mistake. He barred Glacier from competing, fearing it was much too warm to let his prized rookie wrestle. Scott Hall was livid when he heard the news. Hall,
you know who I am!
A Cuban whose heritage exposed him to communist ideology, despised the WCW's working conditions and being labeled an independent contractor. Now, the Federation was preventing one of their own workers from earning a paycheck. It was the final straw. Hall convinced Hulk Hogan to join his crusade against the oppressive bourgeoisie. In a historic protest, Hogan leg-dropped Macho Man and then delivered a rousing speech against capitalism, advocating for a proletarian revolution.
Billionaire Ted, promise me millions of dollars. We will destroy everything in our path, Mean Gene.
He called this violent uprising
the new world order of wrestling, brother.
WCW's front office unfairly punished Glacier for his inadvertent role in this Marxist uprising by refusing to let him work. This wasn't the first time Glacier had faced adversity. His rigorous Japanese training prepared him for these kinds of obstacles. It had transformed him into an ice-cold warrior, ready for battle.
My training? Very specific and intense. We started with stacking huge blocks of frozen ice. We used those blocks to build igloos. Our instructors would actually make us go ice fishing.
NWO continued protesting WCW's treatment of the working class. By the time WCW officials caved to their demands and allowed Glacier to wrestle, 5 months had passed since the original announcement that Glacier was coming.
And welcome back,
unfazed by the delay, Glacier steamrolled his competition with a foolproof strategy.
In every arena, before every match, I'd turn the thermostat down. It would actually get so cold you could see the frost in the air sometimes.
After manipulating the building's air conditioning, Glacier slowly walked to the ring. He'd perform a long kata as cold air blasted into the atmosphere. Opponents were unprepared to fight in the freezing temperatures, especially those wrestlers who didn't wear a shirt or pants. Glacier destroyed his slow-moving opponents with a nimble kung fu and eventually a cryonic kick. For nearly a year, Glacier remained undefeated.
Glacier covers one, two, and he wins again!
But then, he ran into a problem.
One time, I wasn't able to find a thermostat. It's when I faced off against Buff Bagwell. Probably wouldn't have mattered though, because Buff wears a hat. And we all know that 85% of the heat actually escapes through the head.
Glacier lost that match to Buff Bagwell, but a bigger issue loomed overhead. WCW froze his contract for tampering with the thermostat. Unfreezing this contract proved extremely difficult. Glacier sold his things in protest, left wrestling, and embarked on a spiritual quest.
After I left WCW, I wanted a complete change of environment. So I set out to hike every single glacier in Glacier National Park. And eventually, I was looking for the ideal place for year-round training, and I settled on Atlanta, Georgia. Because, as a lot of people know, it gets really hot in Atlanta. But it also gets really, really cold. And when it gets cold, some pretty crazy things can happen.
Our team of glaciologists traveled to Atlanta to study Glacier. After taking the proper precautions not to contaminate the ring, the first thing LuchaLabs scientists observed was that Glacier looks as if he hasn't aged since 1996. He's retained his speed and flexibility, even against opponents half his age. We then exposed Glacier to a temperature of 63.7 degrees Kelvin while eating ice cream as quickly as possible. Our experiment proved Glacier can regulate his brain temperature by controlling his breath. He combats brain freeze by artificially inducing a painkiller function in his upper brainstem. It's almost as if he was naturally manufacturing opioids in his brain in order to control sensory pain. Amazing. Glacier claims cold exposure disciplines the mind, relieves inflammation, and repairs injuries.
Training in the icy, cold elements puts you in a position where you have to think clearly. You have to train the body, the mind, the soul. You have to really focus. All of this is a part of the journey.
Glacier's influence on combat sports is impossible to measure. He started the trend of athletes using ice baths to recover after training. He's even known as the godfather of MMA for combining martial arts and wrestling. This hybrid has become the template for today's fighters.
I studied Muay Thai, Karate, Shaolin Kung Fu, specifically Hung Gar Kung Fu. I took the best of each one of those styles, combined it to make my own unbeatable style that I brought to the professional wrestling ring.
Even though global warming has negatively impacted wrestling, with promotions holding more and more matches outside, Glacier continues to overcome obstacles.
Glacier returned to wrestling. He's remained an in-ring force for 30 plus years. His longevity is due to meditation and cold therapy.
Glacier remains one of the most polarizing figures in all of professional wrestling. Some are adamant there is no one cooler. Others believe he's overhyped. But that's just the tip of the glacier.
I've been wrestling for over 30 years, and I've learned an awful lot of lessons in that wrestling ring. In order to find out who you really are, you've got to put yourself out there. You've got to put yourself in the conditions that really challenge you as a person and as a professional. And as you move through life, just remember this, that no matter how hard things get, no matter how challenging they are, how much they scare you, the best thing you can do is take a deep breath and start on that journey and work hard, have fun, and most of all, never quit. This is Glacier. Make sure you subscribe to LuchaLabs before blood runs cold on you.